We must not let the relics of antiquity be broken and crushed by the savagery of unenlightened creatures. For only by understanding these treasures may we conquer the future. Only we, who have broken free from the shackles of mortality and bound the infinite majesty of the cosmos to our will, can be trusted with this task. That is why we are here, on this wretched pit of a planet. Eliminate these mortals as you see fit, but do try to keep the collateral damage to a minimum.
The galaxy we live in is full to the brim with legends, relics and artifacts. Through stories do we learn from the past, and through treasures do we instill the virtues and lessons of history. For while it is my purview to proclaim the rich truths of my people across the stars, there is another custodian of lore of a more material nature. For today, we shall elucidate the self-styled Archaeovist of the Solemnace Galleries and preserver of the galaxy's collective antiquity, the Necron Conservator, Trazyn the Infinite. Though little is known of Trazyn's origins, it is likely that the aloof custodian has taken painstaking efforts to remove and obscure his past. And who am I to foil his best-laid plans? But I shall offer you a morsel of such knowledge you so greedily hunger for. Once a scribe and chief archivist, Trazyn oversaw the mummification of perished pharaohs and recorded their deeds for the posterity of Necrontyr civilization. His past deeds prior to biotransference a mystery, even unto himself. The self-installed protection protocols often jar with the true events of his past. Believing himself to have been forced into the biofurnaces to achieve transformation, in actuality, Trazyn was alike to the many in willingly embracing the gifts given by the star gods of old. Awakening from his millennia of slumber much earlier than his peers, Trazyn now is an ascended overlord of the Nikilakh Dynasty, saw a great bounty littering the stars. Accruing artifacts from war zones of Eldar, humans, orcs and more, the once meager collection of Trazyn began during the war in heaven, now burgeoned and required a vast repository to store such antiquities. Claiming the world of Solemnace, Trazyn began to construct vast galleries never seen before in the history of the galaxy. Constantly besieged or crumbling under the strain caused by powerful entities trapped within, those that escape their confinement lead to great frustration to be felt by Trazyn as he attempts to recapture or replace his charges. Often twisting the true account of history to complete his projects, exhibits such as the death of Lord Solar Macarius displays holographic Imperial Guard regiments 300 years out of date in their design. Yet what matters are not the small details, but the grand spectacle of each exhibition. Completing each gallery with haste in order to sate his need to achieve satisfactory completion of his venture, Trazyn hopes one day to show his great work to the Necron species with their full awakening. The date of the full awakening of the Necrons unknown to Trazyn, he works tirelessly to collect every conceivable fragment of galactic events before our people reclaim our former glory. And as war erupts across untold billions of holdfasts across the galaxy, innumerable rarities and heirlooms, whether they be objects or even entire sentient races, turn to ash with each passing moment. Working independently from his dynasty, his presence is somewhat tolerated by the Nihilak, though his strange obsession has alienated him from the majority of our people. An unwelcome guest in the court of the mighty Sautek dynasty, despite his unsavory reputation as a thief and scavenger of the galaxy, his spoils are nonetheless of great utility to the Silent King. Driven to preserve every last grain of sand of the proverbial hourglass of history, his collection of priceless trophies forces him to embark upon the galaxy outside the comfort of his own domain. Sending substitutes of his will when possible, Trazyn enjoys nothing more than to roam his vast collections and marvel at the subjects he has so painstakingly preserved. believed to have been slain on several occasions due to his use of substitutes. Many of his Lich Guard have sacrificed their lives in order to fulfill their master's desire to add to his collection. Often commanding his forces to distract his opponents whilst he slips behind enemy lines, Trazyn's hunger for spoils of war, such as notable commanders, the armor of fallen heroic warriors, or the capture of peculiar regiments or battle companies in their entirety, often consternates the Necron dynasties. For a trail about Trazyn the Infinite would be replete without the inclusion of the spoils of his most daring and dangerous of heists. Within the vast vaults of Solemnace, wonders and horrors as young as decades and as ancient as eons fill its boundless chambers. Sequestered into collections defined by the various races of the galaxy, every conceivable being, from humans to orcs to enslavers, stand immobile. An entire Wraithbone choir of the Asuriani Antalsar craftworld, an impeccably preserved Kainite warrior, the last known living Krork warboss of the War in Heaven, and even a Catan shard of the Deceiver, lay within. An entire high fleet of the Tyranid invasion of Vuros, once stored within his exhibition of the interstellar beings, would not remain contained for long, and in its escape, imperil much of Trazyn's vaunted collection. Yet peculiarly, among Trazyn's interests, the Infinite shows a great deal of favor in collecting relics of the human aliens' past. Though a relatively new species to the galaxy, their influence cannot be denied, and as such, Trazyn revels in his collection of relics drawn from the ongoing death knell of this strange species. On the more macabre scale of his collection, Trazyn owns the severed head of Sebastian IV, the ecclesiarch who stood defiant against the crazed human, Goge Vandyre. Hundreds of regiments of the Astra Militarum, such as the Catachan Jungle Fighters, Vestroian Firstborn, the Lost Remnants of Tanif, and even the Lord Castellan of Cadia, Ursicar Creed, have been captured for his display. Both a Thunder Warrior of the Wars of Unification and a custodian of the Emperor of Mankind stand immobile, and this is not to mention the many Adeptus Astartes contingents now trapped within Trazyn's domain. Brother Cassiel of the Blood Angels, when seconded to the Death Watch, would be captured, and in his moment of imprisonment, scream in fear. His twisted expression clear for all to see, forever frozen in time. Salamanders and Raven Guard warriors of the Istvan V Dropsite Massacre, once fated to die among the fires of betrayal, would escape their fate, only to embrace the cold silence of the gallery. Ancient Dusk Raiders, free of the taint of chaos alike to their Death Guard successors, trudge through preserved snow in their marble and red armor. And among the most prized of his possessions, a living clone of the Emperor's Children Primarch, Fulgrim, alike to a sad statue, forever remains immobile and distant from tipping the scales of the war erupting throughout the galaxy. Bargained with the Chief Apothecary of the Emperor's Children Legion, Fabius Bile, in exchange for his freedom and to prevent his gene sire's inevitable downfall from once again wreaking havoc across the stars. Most glorious of his collection is the prismatic galleries replete with countless recaptured events of galactic history deemed worthy to preserve. Transmuting living beings into hard light holograms, conducting loops of their past actions, these souls shall never be released from their unknowing, recurrent undertakings. Stealing not only from aliens, but also the various Necron dynasties, Trazyn has further embittered our people to his antics in his attempts to procure artifacts such as the Staff of the Destroyer from Mandragora. Concealing his identity with pseudonyms such as Nemesor Kushchai or Fantek the Deathless, his pillaging of the galaxy is impossible to fully account for due to his endless trickery and obfuscation of his deeds. Yet not all of Trazyn's attempts to seize his prizes have been successful. Such was the case during his confrontations with the Salamander Astartes, Vulcan Hastan. Twice striving to claim the Spear of Vulcan for his collection, the Forge Father of the Salamanders has bested Trazyn in single combat and prevented the larceny of his chapter's cherished artifact. though Trazyn's continued flagrant attitude towards the galaxy's turmoil does not preclude him from intervening when such conflicts threaten to endanger his spoils. During 999.M41, a threat to the existence of the galaxy loomed large. The bell of St. Gerstal chimed endlessly within the Solemnace gallery to which it was housed as it sounded the alarm for the peril of Cadia after millennia of silence. 13 times did the bell toll, wreaking havoc within the galleries and causing Trazyn to lose 5 of his surrogate bodies in his attempts to silence its chimes. Abaddon the Despoiler, War Master of Chaos Undivided, had enacted his 13th Black Crusade, culminating in the assault of the human fortress world of Cadia. A key stronghold of the Imperium in their endless war of attrition. Should such a planet be destroyed, the forces of Chaos could venture ever closer to their venerated throne world. Realizing that such destruction enabled further ruin of great treasures of history to be lost in the flames of war, the Infinite traveled to Cadia to meet with an unlikely ally. Belisarius Kool, the Archmagos Dominus of the Mechanicus, toiled within the ruins of the planet and meddled with technology of the Necrons. Imparting Belisarius with knowledge regarding the Cadian pylons and their methods of containing the spread of the warp storm, the Eye of Terror, Trazyn offered his aid to save Cadia. Warily accepting the Infinite's offer, Belisarius and Trazyn worked tirelessly to activate the pylons of the Elysian Fields, yet for their efforts be besieged by the forces of the Black Legion. Trazyn released prisoners from his Tesseract labyrinths containing Imperial heroes of old, whilst Belisarius gained increased knowledge of the Necron devices as he worked tirelessly until fully comprehending their mechanisms. Abaddon the Despoiler personally charged into the caverns, collapsing the western wall as he charged the Electro Priests of the Mechanicus defense. Hurling another Tesseract labyrinth into the fray, Trazyn summoned the confined Ultramarines Lieutenant Commander, Cerantes, and his legionaries to aid in the defense. Imprisoned since the dark days of the Horus Heresy, they would march from a crag once again in the Imperium's darkest hour. For Stroyan Firstborn, Tanith soldiers, Salamanders Astartes, and even a custodian of the Emperor aided the defense, as each were released from their long dormancy. Yet it would not be enough. Retreating from the battle, Trazyn allowed for the freedom of the Puritan Inquisitor Greyfax prior to his escape, and once more tilted the balance of power of the galaxy. Pursued by Greyfax as she turned on Trazyn and attempted to slay him, the mind-shackle scarabs implanted by Trazyn into her body prevented her from harming him. Belisarius activated the Cadian pylons, yet only for a brief moment, shrinking the Eye of Terror with a blast of its power. Forcing Abaddon to retreat due to his army's weakening, more drastic actions would be required to fell Cadia. Hurling the Blackstone Fortress, Will of Eternity, under the surface, following its incapacitation by the Imperial Fist Chapter of Astartes, its meteoric fall tore through the planet. The loss of the pylons caused the Eye of Terror to expand greatly, causing the Cicatrix Maledictum, or Great Rift, across the galaxy. Chaos was victorious, and the Imperium, despite the renewal of many of its imprisoned heroes, suffered a catastrophic defeat. Trazyn, for his part, had failed, yet found solace in his intervention, doing all that it could hope to achieve, given the circumstances. Witness to the new great shift of power in galactic history, the Infinite for once in his life relented in his need to acquire a trinket of the event, if only for a moment. Capturing the Lord Castellan Creed, the monument of the defense of Cadia, proved to be a fitting trophy for such a momentous occasion. Though Trazyn's dealings with humanity have positioned him as both a savior and thief, his most infamous feud comes from within the lineage of our own people. Embittered towards the cryptic chronomancer, Orikan the Diviner, the two nobles of the Necron have waged a costly competition of pride and stubbornness to have outlasted even the wars waged between the humans. For 10 millennia, the the two have fought to champion their opposing views on the future of the galaxy. Fighting over the location and contents of the long-lost stasis tomb of the Necrontyr Pharaon of the Amunos dynasty, the Infinite and the Divine managed to sow chaos across the galaxy in their childish contest of wits and wills. Finding the location of the world of Serenade within the eastern fringe of the galaxy, Trazyn sought to rid himself of Orikan by trapping him within the stasis tomb and unleashing a gene stealer to hunt down his rival. Defying the endless misfortune and fatal encounters wrought by Trazyn, Orikan refused to perish by the machinations and manipulations of the Infinite. Serenade burned at the hands of the humans as they enacted exterminatus of the planet following its infestation with a gene stealer cult made in the image of the original interloper deployed by Trazyn. Entombing Orikan within the ruins of Serenade for 100 years, Trazyn's unbelievable scheming caused Orikan to befall the same fate time and again, no matter how many times he changed the events of history in his favor to circumvent his peril. Finding the true purpose of the tomb to be containing a shard of the Catan, Mefetran the Deceiver, the two would be forced to work together to prevent calamity from spreading from Serenade. Transforming Orikan into a godlike being of pure light with the use of a precious Eldar gemstone from his collection, though Orikan's newly gained power proved sufficient to pacify the fragments of the Star God, such a trial would only further reinforce their resentment of one another. Swearing to one day achieve vengeance against Trazyn for his actions, Orikan plots to humble the Infinite and has seemingly not learned from his recent encounter. For even I would think twice before attempting to hector the disreputable Collector.
Dear lady, let me express my fulsome appreciation for your most generous gift. It is so very rare to discover another of my own kind that appreciates my work. Therefore, divine understanding amongst a member of another race is nothing short of a revelation. I realize that you briefly trod my galleries, but the fact that you spotted in so short a time that my Acabrius War Collection was lacking 3 regiments of Catachan warriors reveals that you truly have a collector's eye for detail. And to send 5 regiments! Such generosity will allow me to weed out and replace a few of the more substandard pieces of my collection. If I might level a minor criticism, the instructions issued to your gift were manifestly not as clear as you thought, as most of them had to be forcibly restrained. Sadly, it seems that the lower orders will always behave like an army of invasion, whether that be their purpose or not. However, this is a minor complaint, and seems almost churlish under the circumstance, so please allow me to repay your gift with one of my own. Accompanying this message is the Hyperstone Maze, one of a series of Tesseract labyrinths constructed at the height of the Charnavok dynasty. It is a trinket, really, only of interest to scholars such as you and I, but I trust you will find it amusing, assuming you have the wit to escape its clutches, of course.
This has been a tale of the Infinite Empire, read by the Omniscient. Most mortal beings do not comprehend the extent of the history of the universe. Time and again they fall to the altar of hubris and arrogance in their attempt to reach enlightenment. For all his flaws, Trazyn understands one thing above all, that time is merciless and unrelenting in its inevitable expanse into new forms of life, events, and downfalls. The beings that are its heroes and villains are but pawns to the whims of the amusements of fate, and none with any sense are foolish enough to fight an enemy such as Trazyn, whom is at best apathetic to the outcome of the game.